here on the East Coast, always in the air. These folks are ready as their guys get set to match up with the Indianapolis Colts. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Now whistles, and we've got a man down. A man down here following the kickoff. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. They'll run for the first time with Peyton Barber. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
They'll run for the first time with Antonio Gibson. Some fancy footwork, but not much room to operate. Just up past the 25 and no further. And Thomas seems to be in some pain. He's still on the ground. We'll check on his status when we get back. An early tough test on the opening drive. This is 3rd and 8. Fitzpatrick slings this deep from McLaurin. And that will be incomplete. And they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down.
And that's exactly what defenses talk about. You've got to find ways to get off the field when you can, especially on 3rd down. A 3rd down defense going to be vital in this game. Able to knock that one away and force a 4th down.
So on 4th down, Washington going to call on Tress Way to punt it away. Back deep, Nyheim Hines. It'll be a net of 39. 41-yard punt, 2 on the return. And the Colts will go on offense here, 1st and 10. They'll fake the give to Taylor. Now Wentz. And the pressure will get to him. He goes down. Now there is a flag on the play, but this looks like holding on the offense. They're backed up here with a 1st and 20 now after the holding penalty. They'll run the toss here with Taylor. And some room to work. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. A big pickup there on the run.
A great run, yes, but something you pointed out to me on film is when they get outside the tackles, their wide receivers are really good at blocking.
And this is a team that values those wide receivers actually blocking. They actually get congratulated and noted for their blocking during a game. They can have a 10-catch game, but if they don't block well, it's going to be a long week for them in practice.
And he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43. Just what you want on a 1st down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2. Wentz going to give this to Taylor. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a 1/2 yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
So 3rd and 2, this quite possibly 4-down territory, though, if they're stopped. They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. 44 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4-down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
1st and 10, Taylor now. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call run fits, everyone was in the right place.
On play action, it's Wentz. And he cannot avoid the pressure as the Washington pass rush gets home.
Deron Payne gets him for a loss of 8. What great push up front. Now after the sack, Wentz and the Colts, they're left looking at a 3rd and long. Nyheim Hines, his first carry. And a good tackle there right around the 30. Stops him short of the first down. It'll be a pickup of 13, but it'll still lead to a 4th down.
This offense really put themselves in a tough spot on 1st and 2nd down, needing long yardage to try and pick up a 1st down. And they ended up getting a great run. Explosive, picked up nice yardage. You don't expect to be in this situation on 4th down. But guess what? It all started with what happened on 1st and 2nd down. Really put them behind the 8 ball.
They were probably hoping to get him a little bit closer for a shorter field goal, but he was able to get it done from deep.
Nice little tester for him to begin things, huh? I think he was hoping for a little bit more of a chip shot. Instead, they made him stretch it out a little bit, but he's got to feel great now that he put it through the pipes.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Here's Sims to return. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And the first drive, 3 and out. 2nd possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. A run here for J.D. McKissic. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. He's able to rattle off 6 on the carry, and that'll get him to 3rd and 4.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved him and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
And for the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on 3rd down. Throwing Fitzpatrick. To the right side and complete to Thomas. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. 3rd and 4, he did just enough. I mean, just enough to move the chains.
And that's all you're looking for, right? Just want to keep the drive moving. You don't need the big play there. Just get to that marker that you described, and he was able to do just that.
They go play action. Fitzpatrick. Now he'll escape to his left. Boy, that is a 7-yard loss. 2nd down now. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. A hole to dig out of here. 2nd and 17. From the gun, Fitzpatrick. Incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. To throw, Fitzpatrick. Flush to his right. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
3rd and long, dare we say 3rd and a mile. Pass rushers in sprinter stances. They know they've got a chance to get after him on this play. And somehow he finds a way past him, gets away and takes off and picks up a 1st down. Can you believe it? Wow.
1st down, Fitzpatrick. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards. Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Fitzpatrick.
They always say that real estate is about location. Well, guess what? When it's a slant route, the quick ones, timing, timing, timing. You got to be able to lead your man with the football.
And the timing off right there. Threw it behind him. The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. Now Fitzpatrick. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another 1st down at the Colts 23.
Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get down.
Yeah, that
first.
Wasn't the first option.
No, not it came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
Fitzpatrick now to throw on 1st down. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Thomas. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8.
But when you hit him on the move like that, he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam. Oh, boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. Fitzpatrick. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over it, and they got there to break that one up.
Nothing on 1st down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, 2nd and goal. Working out of the gun, Fitzpatrick. Eluding the pressure right. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Ryan Fitzpatrick, an 8-yard touchdown run. And Washington has taken the lead.
I'd have to say we're all a little bit surprised there because at his age, with his speed, or should I say lack thereof, the only rushing touchdowns I would expect are on quarterback sneaks. But here, he found all of his guys covered. He said, why not? And by the way, if that doesn't fire up your team to see the veteran like that risking his body for the touchdown, I don't know what will.
Touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. Rodgers on the return. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And after the field goal last time, see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I've never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
They'll run on 1st down. Taylor. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
A big part of a middle linebacker's job is being able to take on blocks and then go make plays. But the best ones, they have those big guys in front of them playing defensive line to hold blockers off of them and allow them to flow sideline to sideline and make the big hits.
2nd down, another run with Taylor. And he'll get this up to about the 40. 5 yards, now it's 3rd and 5.
He was brought down by Tom Fisher. 5 yards on the play. And it's third down.
From the gun on third down, Wentz. It's complete here to T.Y. Hilton. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open in key situations.
Flushed out right. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
Here's 2nd and a yard. To throw, it's Wentz. He's got his target. That's Zach Pascal. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. They had to settle for 3 last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in 6. In good position, 1st and 10. Wentz's throw into the hands of Pittman here. Now the Colts going to burn the 2nd of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number 1. From down at the 12, it's 1st and 10. Now Wentz. That is incomplete.
Well, he left no doubt about that one because even though he hasn't left the pocket, he's got a receiver in the area, so it's not grounding, even though there's no way that ball was going to be caught.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Shotgun now for to the end zone, but it's incomplete. This drive, which was going so smoothly, all of a sudden it's a little bit of a roadblock here with 2 straight incompletions.
Yeah, apparently this defense has had enough. Apparently they're saying no more. We're making a stand right here, right now. But it is 3rd and 10. They've got to get after him one more time.
This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. Again, it's Wentz. Got a man, it's Pittman, and he hauls it in for the Colts touchdown. Michael Pittman there to make the grab, and the Colts are going to jump back in front.
All drives that result in points hurt a defense, but when they are the sustained variety, play after play, and they just can't get off the field and stop them, that can be demoralizing.
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and the lead is now 10-7. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. And Sims says, let's bring it out to the 25. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And with him trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get in the field goal range. And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Washington going to go on offense now late in this first half. And with great starting field position and a couple of timeouts at their disposal, they'll certainly have the green light here. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now Fitzpatrick. And Thomas has it. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. To throw is Fitzpatrick. Throw right side is going to be caught by Samuel. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
My goodness, they've come out locked in on this drive. Play calling, execution, they are fully in sync. Three straight passes, three first downs. They're moving the ball downfield almost at will. This defense really struggling to find answers.
A first down throw for Fitzpatrick. This to McLaurin out on the left side. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Second and six. Fitzpatrick now. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Now Washington going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Now the defense, they'll spread the field a dime package here on third and 12. From the shotgun, it's Fitzpatrick. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down. So we come to halftime here with the visiting Colts taking the lead to the locker room as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for an REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Bringing it out of his end zone, Isaiah Rodgers. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in this second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be licensed to take some shots downfield.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. The give to Taylor. Taylor's got the first down and more. And finally taken down at the 35-yard line. 94 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. He had a really solid first half running the football and picking up where he left off here in the third quarter.
How about the yardage he's piling up right now? This feels like a full game, not just this series that we're watching right now. I know people are screaming, where are the adjustments from halftime on the defensive side of the ball? Sometimes they're just not there. Sometimes you just got to find a way to tackle someone.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
On first down, It's Taylor. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, they've had success on the ground on this drive, and that makes a defense more likely to overcommit to stop the run as they did on that play. But keep in mind, it makes them susceptible to play-action passes as well.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Now Wentz. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Had an open man that time. We ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. On the delay, here's Hines. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. He lost two, and it brings up fourth.
Well, we saw a lot of negative plays that resulted in plenty of lost yardage in the first half, and that trend is continuing here.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first one, this from 44 yards out now. Blankenship's kick is good. And the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. Well, looking at it from a defensive perspective, that keeps a deficit very, very manageable. You know, all things considered, not a bad job on the defensive side.
I would say that you've pointed out something pretty good right there, and that is you actually have both sides happy with that exchange. You know, happy in quotes, of course. One team, hey, we've kept it within range. The other side saying, hey, we put points on the board and did stretch out the lead. Let's see how this one turns out.
Yeah, still bottom line, though, 3 points for the opening drive of the third quarter. One away. Here's Sims to return. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
Fitzpatrick to throw it. Looking again for Thomas, this time complete. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. Here's Fitzpatrick. And he'll be brought down by the Colts. Ben Banigou drops him for a loss of 12, and it also brings up fourth down. Well, he was really focused downfield, but there was really no viable options. The coverage was too good.
And the defense really quickened the tempo of that play with their pass rush because there was nowhere for him to go with the football. The only place he ended up, down on the ground.
Oh, what a move. It'll be a 47-yard punt with a net of 40 following a 7-yard return. And out will come the offense as they take over. A carry by Taylor to start the drive. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. 111 yards on the ground for him so far.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Second down and three. They go to the ground again with Taylor. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, third and five.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside.
If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. That's complete to Jack Doyle, the tight end. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Now a handoff. Taylor with it. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Okay, he didn't break that one all the way, but you got to know that he feels like he's right on the verge, and that's probably exactly what he's telling them in the huddle right now.
Second down, another run with Taylor. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Working from the gun, Wentz. Escaping the pressure right. And Wentz going to slide to a stop. He does have the first down. It's a gain of 10. Now they'll throw it. Wentz. This is caught. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. So 1st and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Taylor. Give him 4 on the carry there. It's 2nd and goal.
Can we just take that run and turn it into a kind of a clip and save? Because that tells you everything you need to know about this drive. They've been moving the ball awfully well.
This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on 2nd down. Here's Taylor again. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up 3rd down.
And now 3rd and goal coming up, the loss on 2nd down. That just means this crowd's going to get even louder, and they'll get a little bit of extra help from the defenders as they exhort them to join them in the effort.
Wentz now on 3rd and goal. That ball is caught. It's Doyle. Touchdown, Colts. A 5-yard touchdown catch, and the Colts add on to their lead.
You got to figure down by the goal line, this is where a tight end earns his money, in the high traffic area. And he's able to work free in the middle of the end zone and grabs that one for a touchdown.
Wentz going to look to throw, and this one's caught. And their 4th quarter lead grows by a couple more. He hits the big target for the 2-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. Here's Sims to return. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Second and 10. Here's Fitzpatrick. They'll set up the screen for Gibson. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. That'll leave them with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
And that doesn't have to gain big yardage to be an impactful play, because if you get those pass rushers second-guessing themselves, that they might get hit with a screen, maybe you can wind up slowing them down just a step. And if you do that, that's a win for that play.
Fitzpatrick on third and two. And he finds McLaurin. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
To the air again, Fitzpatrick. Flush to his right. And he works free. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down. And this will probably be the final play before the 2-minute warning. From just shy of midfield, Fitzpatrick. Thomas has got it. Complete. And he will get enough for a first down, and that will lead us to the 2-minute warning. Fitzpatrick on first down. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
A lot of practice time, a lot of thinking goes into 2-minute drills, even on the defensive side. So now you want to make sure the guys understand. Continue to be aggressive, but make sure you're smart in doing so.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Fitzpatrick. That's complete out of that, so they're left with a third and 3. Clock running, about to hit 90 seconds to go in the game. Here's Fitzpatrick. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Well, give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Completes it to Samuel. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I'd look down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays that have been successful throughout the game that have worked at the distance you need, and that's exactly what they got done.
Counting down toward a minute to go in this football game. Fitzpatrick to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. First down now, but that clock rolling. Fitzpatrick. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And Washington now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go. So not quite a first and goal just yet as they come up now second and inches. They'll throw again. Fitzpatrick looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
And now defensively in the two-minute drill, the big key to me, make sure you understand your assignments, and anytime you get a chance to tackle someone in bounds, get them on the ground.
An incomplete pass on second down leads us to third and inches. Fitzpatrick to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, this defense has been physical all game long, and it certainly looks like they're not going to back off and make things any easier. They want to keep making life miserable for the receivers all the way to the end.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. Desperation time. Fitzpatrick on fourth down. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and it'll be a turnover. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ballgame. Indy set to go on offense once more. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
The last run got six, now second and four. Again, it's Taylor. And just not much to be had there. 1 yard out to the 10. Now Washington going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game. On third down, here's Taylor. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. So this one winds up an Indianapolis victory, and it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment.
Big deal. Whoa, here I go.